Hello everyone. So the other day we took a look at Battery Saver, and a fair few people also asked me to have a look at Juice Defender. There seems to be a bit of a split in the community as to which is the best. I think personally both apps are approaching the problem slightly differently. With Battery Saver, what it's doing is using the deep sleep mode within the phone to effectively turn off the vast majority of the phone's power using features for a set period of time, then it wakes up, then it does its actions, and then goes back to sleep again. With Juice Defender, things are a little bit more granular than that. What you can actually do is it's not really about deep sleep so much as disabling particular features. So if you're in custom and you go into settings, you can enable or disable the mobile data, the Wi-Fi, various options for the Wi-Fi, how it will actually operate. Wi-Fi is preferred or auto-disable. Your location setting, so is it going to use the GPS? When to schedule these various features for, and how long it will do those options for as well. A lot of this does feel quite similar to deep sleep, but it doesn't seem to be completely across the entire device. It's only dealing with things like your location and your Wi-Fi and the mobile data, which may be much more useful to people. Obviously, if you've got no mobile data, no Wi-Fi, no location, you're practically in deep sleep anyway. But this gives quite a nice amount of granular control over it, which I quite like. You also have a night mode as well, so that, you know, obviously at night, it just turns this stuff off. Really useful. Apps configuration as well, so you can actually set the priority on particular apps by the looks of it. So if you want an app to be able to wake up, then you can. I've been playing with the app for about 24 hours, and yesterday I certainly found that the battery life was good. I wasn't using the device for a huge amount of different things, so it was more kind of just general running the device, kind of sitting and sleeping most of the time, I would have thought, using these various controls. And yeah, I would say I did feel like I was getting more battery life for my time, as it were. Hard to put an exact amount on it, I'm going to have to do a bit more testing, but certainly good app. I think both these apps are really approaching the issue of saving battery in slightly different ways. Which one is better? I would say use both and see which one works for you and then stick with that one. Obviously install one, use it, test it, see what kind of battery life you get and whether that fits in with your routine and the way you actually use your device. If not, try the other one. One of them is going to be perfect for you. I personally, just because of the way I use my device, I'm leaning towards Battery Saver. For me, I think that's the better overall kind of approach to dealing with this. Also, with Juice Defender, they do seem to want to charge you for a pro version. Although I think there's actually three or four different versions. Have a quick look at compare features. Yeah, there's three different versions, an ultimate, a plus, and a free. We're looking at the free version here, by the way. So within the plus version, there's quite a few more options, but obviously the ultimate one is the one that gets you everything, including Bluetooth and GPS control, CPU frequencies, etc. For the ultimate one, a lot of those I would have thought would be for roots only, so you'd have to have a rooted device. But certainly with the free ones, some of these I would have thought should work regardless. But not a bad application.